Here we will see window authentication in ASP.NET. Window authentication is the easiest way to implement in an application. It makes use of authentication capabilities and used with all the authentication methods provided by the IIS. It is implemented when the users are part of Windows. Here the code is executed with the same security as that of Windows. When the user requests a specific request, it goes to the IIS. IIS authenticates the user and attaches the token to it. It passes the authentication request and security token to the ASP.NET. The token is verified by the ASP.NET in the authorization section of the web.config. There are four types of Windows authentication methods. Anonymous authentication, where IIS allows any user. Basic authentication, here Windows username and password has to be sent across the network. These passwords and usernames are in plain text format, hence they are not very secure. Digest authentication. Same as basic authentication, but the credentials are encrypted and it works only on Internet Explorer 5 or above. And integrated Windows authentication, which relies on Kerberos technology with strong credential encryption. First, we'll see anonymous authentication. Anonymous authentication gives user access to the public areas of your web or FTP site without prompting them for a username or password. Basic concepts of anonymous authentication are: no authentication occurs in either IIS or ASP.NET. It is a good choice for publicly available websites that not require the identity of the user. And there are no browser restrictions in anonymous authentication. Consider anonymous authentication when the caller name and or password is not required for logon or business logic components. The information you are protecting is considered public. And do not use anonymous authentication when you require a logon name and password. To implement anonymous authentication, in web.config file under system.web, set the authentication mode equal to none. Next, we'll see basic authentication. Here the authentication is used for instructing the browser to send the user credentials over HTTP. The user is authenticated against the Windows credentials. The user has an account on the server domain. To enable the basic authentication, set the authentication mode to Windows in the web.config file. The working of a basic authentication is as mentioned below. Browser prompts the user with dialog box. Usernames and passwords are sent using Base64 encoding, which is not secure. Consider the basic authentication when you require that users to have Windows NT domain or Active Directory accounts. Support for multiple browsers. Support for authentication over the internet. Access to clear text word in your application code. And delegation. And do not use basic authentication when you require storage of information in a custom database and a customized form presented to the user as a logon page. To implement basic authentication, configure your IIS server for basic authentication. Configure your user accounts to have logon locally enabled on the web server. And configure your ASP.NET web.config file under system.web, set authentication mode equal to Windows. Next is digest authentication. This concept is new to Windows 2000 and IIS 5.0. It encrypts the user password using MD5. It depends on the browser and server capabilities, and it cannot perform delegations. Consider digest authentication when the web server is running Windows 2000 and users have Windows account stored in Active Directory. All clients use either the .NET platform or Internet Explorer 5.0 or later. Password encryption above that of basic authentication is required, and support of authentication over the internet is required. Do not use digest authentication when some clients use platforms other than .NET or Internet Explorer 5.0 or later. Users do not have Windows accounts stored in Active Directory, and delegation is required. Other considerations for digest authentication are: consider digest authentication when you require security. Digest authentication is more secure than basic authentication. It is less secure than basic authentication with SSL, that is security socket layer. It can also be combined with SSL. Platform requirements for digest authentication are: authentication clients, .NET or Internet Explorer 5.0 or later, and server which running Active Directory with user accounts configured for digest authentication. To implement digest authentication, configure your IIS for digest authentication and configure the ASP.NET web.config file under system.web set authentication mode equal to Windows. Next is integrated Windows authentication. This Windows authentication uses either NTLM challenge or response or Kerberos to authenticate users with a Windows NT domain or Active Directory account. Here no word is sent across the network. It is best suited to an intranet environment, and it works with Internet Explorer 3.01 or later. Consider integrated Windows authentication when users have Windows NT domain or Active Directory accounts, when your application runs on an intranet, all clients are running Internet Explorer 3.01 or later, delegation is required, and seamless logon procedure for domain users is required. Do not use integrated Windows authentication when user accounts are stored in an external database. Authentication over the internet is required. Clients are using non-Microsoft browsers, and when you need the client's clear text word. To implement Windows authentication, clients and servers must be running on Windows 2000. In Windows 2000, domain user and services accounts must be enabled for delegation. Configure IIS for integrated Windows authentication and then configure the ASP.NET web.config file under system.web set authentication mode equal to Windows.